Steve, we were talking about the flying flea just now, yeah. Which you describe as being the most dangerous aircraft in this hangar, and we're looking at, you know, mosquitoes and all sorts of really serious aeroplanes. There's even a Buccaneer over there somewhere. And yet the reason for that was that this particular aircraft had a tendency to kill its passenger,
its pilot.
The Daily Mail used to give sets of plans of these out. It was the world's first microlite, and thousands of people built them in their back garages, in their yards, in their sheds, in all sorts of places. Eventually, 600 of them took to the air. And out of that 600, exactly half, 300, killed their pilots. And they killed their pilots because there was one very dangerous design flaw. Under certain circumstances, the airflow over the back wing would accelerate.
Because it's an extraordinary shape, isn't it? I'm just going to cross in front of you here and go around the back, because this isn't a shape that many people would recognise. It's got this sort of second wing here.
It is. It's designed by a guy who couldn't learn to coordinate his hands and feet, and therefore couldn't coordinate ailerons for turns. So he designed this exceptionally curved wing, which gave an aileron effect when you tilted it back. But unfortunately, it also increased the lift on the back wing. So as you were coming in to land, you'd pull back on the stick to flare for your landing, and instead of lifting the nose, it dropped the nose very severely, and suddenly you're trying to fly underground. 300 of the pilots out of 600 that took off died. The aeroplane was banned throughout the world, apart from America, I believe.
And there's still one flying, I think you said.
And there is still one flying, but that was designed by somebody who knew what he was doing, and he gave greater separation between the two wings.